we, as folk are still coming into the room, we just wanted to say hello and good evening. Welcome to the Career and Technical Education Virtual High School Fair. Before we get started, we will be sharing call-in information for the language lines. First, we would like to introduce the Spanish language line.
Hi, good evening, everyone. This is Gustavo, one of the Spanish interpreters, along with Alejandro, and the following message will be said in Spanish. Hola, muy buenas tardes. Si desea escuchar esta reunión en español, por favor, marque el número 347-966-4114 e ingrese el código 520-640-507 y tecla numeral. De nuevo, el número es el 347-966-4114 y el código es 520-640-507 y tecla numeral. Por favor, mantengan sus micrófonos apagados durante la reunión y gracias. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And next we will have the Arabic.
Thank you. This announcement will be in Arabic. Assalamu alaikum ala raghibin bil husul ala at-tarjuma bil lugha al-arabiyya al-ittisal ala raqam 347-966-4114. Ba'daha ad-daghth ala ramz al-dakhli 665-568-603 ba'daha alamat al-hashtag aw al-shubbat. مرة أخرى على الراغبين بالحصول على الترجمة باللغة العربية الاتصال على نمرة التليفون 347-966-4114 بعدها الضغط على رمز 665-568-603 بعدها علامة الهاشتاج أو الشباك على الراغبين بسماع الترجمة بصورة واضحة وضع الميكروفون على الميوت أو الصامت لكي تستطيع سماع الترجمة باللغة العربية سوف نقوم بالإجابة على أسئلتك واستفساراتك في نهاية هذه الأمسية. مرة أخرى على الراغبين بسماع الترجمة باللغة العربية الاتصال على رقم التليفون 347-966-4114 بعدها الضغط على رمز 665-568-603 بعدها علامة الهاشتاج أو الشباك. شكرا. Arabic announcement has been completed. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And finally this evening we will have the French.
Yeah, hello everybody. This is Gierno, one of your French interpreter of the day. The following message will be in French. Bonsoir tout le monde, vous qui participez à la réunion. Si vous voulez participer, vous composez le numéro 347-966-4114, suivi du code PIN 737-782-468, suivi de yes, 737-782-468, suivi de yes. Rassurez-vous que votre micro est arrêté si vous n'avez pas la parole, et que si vous voulez participer, vous libérez votre micro sur l'ordinateur et posez directement votre question. Je répète encore, si vous voulez participer pour cette réunion en français, vous composez le numéro 347-966-4114, suivi du code PIN 737-782-468 CBDS. Merci de votre attention. French interpretation announcement already completed.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
All right. So once again, thank you. We would like to welcome students, families, administrators, and the rest of the community. Tonight, we would like to introduce families to the advantages of joining the CTE community. We would also like to share some information about the larger CTE community, our partnerships, and the opportunities that we provide our students. We will share some information about our academic rigor, the variety of program models. I'm sorry, next slide, please, sorry. and some of the ways in which our students prepare for the next steps of college and career. Then some of our schools will share in their own words what makes them such special places to learn. We will discuss next steps, and finally, we will have a brief question and answer session if time permits. We'd also like to let families know that in lieu of the question and answer session, you can always drop your questions into the Q&A now, and someone will be available to start answering questions there. Next slide, please. The mission of our CTE programs is to ensure that all students graduate college and career ready, and to provide a high value strategy to support both students' post-secondary aspirations and the strength of the city's economy. Next slide, please. Next again. We work to achieve this mission through a three-pronged approach to learning: rigorous academics, work-based learning, and post-secondary connections. All of these steps are informed by our constantly evolving relationship with industries across the city and state. In order to graduate, every CTE student must pass 44 academic classes like every other high school student. Unlike other high schools, 7 of these credits are technical classes where students learn the skills that industry professionals agree will continue to be in demand. All CTE students must participate in a minimum of 54 hours of work-based learning experiences. Some of these experiences are paid. Some are academic credit bearing. All of these experiences are designed to introduce students to the challenges that professionals face daily and help students to begin to develop the skills that they will need to solve tomorrow's problems. Finally, our students who are preparing to leave our schools, we have developed a network of colleges that offer our students advanced placement and early credits and other post-secondary opportunities, meaning that our students can potentially accelerate through college as they discover what their future will be. Next slide, please. CTE is comprised of 16 industry-based areas of study, including architecture, audiovisual technology and communication, health sciences. Today, we will focus on 2 examples of our programming. Next slide, please. First, we will look at media technology and design area of study. Within media and tech, we see that we have 29 program types varying from broadcast journalism to web design. Students curious about media and design have a wide range of career-based skills to explore. We would also like to take a moment to discuss the value of stackable credentials. CTE students, as part of their coursework, take industry certification exams to prove proficiency in certain skill areas. Next slide, please. This is one of the places where CTE's program value is apparent. As we cover the cost of tests such as Adobe, Avid Pro Tools, but also tests like the OSHA 30. These certification exams are highly valuable as they are industry recognized and stay with the student after graduation. Next slide, please. The Justice Resource Center is another example of our programs that work with schools. The JRC is New York's leading provider of law-related and civic education programs that are geared to a diverse school-age population. Students learn about the functions of government, their roles and responsibilities as citizens, and develop a heightened respect for the law. Each school is paired with a mentor law firm. Students receive one-on-one guidance on oral advocacy from experienced and professional attorneys. Next slide, please. Another group of CTE schools that we are really proud of are the 9 to 14 schools. In the 9 to 14 model, Students have the opportunity to gain college credits up through an associate's degree and gain vital work-based learning experience, all while in high school. Next slide, please. CTE is also represented among the specialized high schools. There are four specialized high schools with CTE programs: Brooklyn Technical High School, Fiorello H. LaGuardia High School, the High School for Math, Science, and Engineering, and Staten Island Technical High School. Next slide, please. Another major component of the CTE high school experience is work-based learning. All students are provided with a full range of opportunities throughout their engagement in career-related programs of study, with the opportunity to participate in authentic work-based learning experiences at each level of the WBL continuum. Employers and community partners provide WBL opportunities that make sense for their organization, work for the business, and provide direct benefits to the student, the employer, and the school. Our programs are designed to provide a scaffolded experience. First, helping students build awareness of opportunity, then helping explore their career interests, all while preparing students for a fast evolving future. Next slide, please. One of the last advantages that we'd like to discuss is our college network. Next slide, please. Our relationships with CUNY, SUNY, and other learning institutions means that students can enter college with advanced standing for things they've learned in high school. As you can see in this slide, for example, students from no less than four industry sectors can get credits at Borough of Manhattan Community College, for example, including up to 9 credits for students in the healthcare sector. Again, assuming cost per credit, CTE students can save time and potentially thousands of dollars in education costs. Next slide, please. Now, we would like to show a brief video highlighting CTE Career Discovery Week, an annual series of events specifically for CTE students to engage business leaders across the city. Thank you for that. And now we would like to showcase our Manhattan and Bronx schools. First, we'd like to introduce BOSS, the Business of Sports School. Do we have a representative from BOSS here this evening?
Hi there, Mr. Jardine. Am I saying it correctly?
Jardine, but it's quite all right. Jardine. Go ahead, Ms. Dominique.
Hey, so before we play the video, it's so funny because the Career Discovery Week, I just saw a bunch of students and myself. We had gone to Peloton and Goldman Sachs on those field trips, and it was awesome. So I just want to let everybody know that's one of the great opportunities that you have regarding networking and getting out there. These are great field trips that the DOE had hosted. So just to introduce our school, Business of Sports School, it's a great school. I am a teacher there. I am, sorry, I have a little bit of a thing in my throat. And I am a, what they call a career changer. So I actually bring my expertise from the real world to the teaching field. And I've been there for the last 6 years at the Business of Sports School. It's my first school since I changed careers, and I love it. Great teachers, great school. The teachers that I work with are so creative, and we have access to so many contacts, and it gives students the opportunity to network. So if you are interested, before Mr. Jardine puts on our video, which covers everything, we are having our own virtual and live tours. So the virtual tour will be January 25th, 6 to 7. And it's also on our website at nycboss.org. And on Tuesday, January 27th, we're having an in-person open house. And that's 6 to 7. You could find that on the website. And that's pretty much it. I guess, Mr. Jardine, is everybody going to be able to get in touch with the schools? Like, is there going to be a list of schools?
We will be sharing this video on the CTE website, but they can also email us at, well, I'll share the email that they can contact us at the end of the video. Also, okay. Quickly, your video link is the nycboss.org videos, correct?
Yes, sir.
Fantastic. All right, so that'll be coming up shortly.
Okay, thank you, everyone.
Sorry, Larry, can we go back and play her video quickly? Thank you.
If you're late, and then they give you a slip for you to go to detention.
Just like that.
And then you get your slip.
This right here is our lunchroom.
On this side, we have our ninth grade freshman side, where only the ninth grade and freshmen stay.
Yes. And this side is where the sophomores, juniors, and seniors stay most of the time.
These are the lockers for the freshmen. These are all the lockers you guys know.
So this is the freshman English classroom. You'll most likely have Miss Connor or another teacher.
And Miss Elder.
And Miss Elder.
Mr. Berger and Miss Espinetti's classroom, which is freshman algebra one. And on this side, we have Miss Ross's classroom, which is also freshman algebra.
And Mr. Danny.
Okay, so this is the main office. Right here.
Hi, Dr. Solomon.
Hi.
He's really
nice guy.
Yeah, he is.
It's nice to see you guys.
And here's the assistant principals. We got Ms. Rucker.
Hi, everyone. Hi, guys.
And in this class, we have 12th grade business classes. So we have career and finance, accounting, sports management, and virtual enterprise with Mr. Tanel and Mr. Smith. So this is the sixth floor, and this is our shared room. Our shared floor.
Yeah.
Here is the nurse's office where all three schools go.
At the college office, where you see your college advisor.
So the guidance counselor for 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th. Basically, you all have, for different grades, you have different counselors, but whenever you need any type of like working papers, advice, anything, you can come here. This is the earth science classroom. It's also a lab. So this right here is the library. You can rent out books, you can come here during lunch. They got computers that you can play games on if you want to during lunch. Also, this is where we have our family meetings. The family meeting is where we all like join together and talk about like the marking period
every
of the semester.
Every 10th grader.
So this right here is the weight room. This is like an alternative to gym. So if you don't want to do gym, you can also come here. This is one of our computer rooms where you take your business classes. In 10th grade, you start taking business classes with computer applications. And in computer applications, you take three tests: Microsoft Word, Microsoft PowerPoint, and Microsoft Excel. If you take all those three tests and you pass them, you will have a CTE certificate and it will equal a Regents.
Welcome, this is the entrepreneurship class. Basically in entrepreneurship, you take it in 11th grade, and what you do is they introduce you to businesses and everything, like what it takes to start your own business. You start your own business, and if you wanna keep want to continue it, you could, but if you don't want to, you could finish and like end it. But basically, this is where we take entrepreneurship.
In 12th grade, we continue to take more business classes, which are career and finance, accounting, virtual enterprise, and sports management. In virtual enterprise, we continue our businesses, which are where we continue to make an online business for the school, where you become in different groups. You have CEO, CFO, and marketing and technology.
What time does school start?
School starts at 8:20 a.m. Make sure you're here at 8:10.
Is there ever scanning?
Yes, we have scanning occasionally. Sometimes there may be scanning and sometimes there may not.
What's the lateness policy?
The lateness policy is that if you are later than 8:20, you have to have your phone ready and your ID to hand it in, and you will get it back at the end of the day after you serve detention.
So we don't wear uniform. This is optional. If you want to wear it, you could, but it's not mandatory.
What kind of AP courses does BOSS have?
AP has 4 AP courses. We have AP English, AP Psychology, AP Spanish, and AP US History.
What do you like about BOSS, or what would you like prospective students to know about BOSS?
What I would like people to know, and what I like about BOSS, is that there's always somebody you can trust in the building. So let's say, for example, if you want to talk to the guidance counselor, they're always available. If you want to talk any teacher in this building, if you want to talk to them, they're available. They always make you feel like you're like safe here, and like it's a comfortable area. Mm-hmm.
So what I like about BOSS is the programs like iMentor and Big Brothers Big Sisters, because like you have basically a big sister or a mentor, and they're very helpful, and they like help you out with a bunch of stuff, and it's just fun to see them go to a bunch of trips with them, you know.
What I like about BOSS is it inspired me to start my own business. As we are a business school, they give you many resources and a lot of outside links so you could be successful in your future life.
Great. Thank you, guys.
Fantastic. And next, we will be hearing from Chelsea, CTE High School.
Welcome, 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 prospective students to Chelsea CTE High School, home of the Lions. I'm Assistant Principal Dixon, and I'm here to share with you just a little bit about what makes Chelsea CTE a very special place. Hopefully, at this point in your virtual tour, you've learned all about our 3 dynamic CTE majors. So that's CTech, Cisco, and Graphic Design. But did you know that we also have a special team of advisors who are dedicated solely to supporting you and your family with completing applications, connecting you with apprenticeships, career and college reps, tours, and opportunities. But we're not just about academics. You will grow as a person and have a lot of fun at Chelsea CTE. Number one, we're located in the SoHo section of Manhattan, which is just an awesome neighborhood for you to explore when you go outside for lunch, during local field trips, and when you're working with some of our neighborhood and industry partners. Number two, you also enjoy forming lifelong friendships with students from all 5 boroughs, representing just about every culture, race, ethnicity, gender identity, and faith that you could think of, because Chelsea CTE is a safe space for a diverse student body. Number three, we also like to take a holistic approach to preparing our students for careers in the technical fields. So in addition to academics, our faculty and staff members are actually certified to lead our community in mindfulness, restorative, and wellness practices. And this happens on a consistent weekly basis. And finally, because we are a smaller school, you will receive more hands-on attention, time, and support with your academic courses. We actually know every student by name because we care about our students and we want to get to know you as a person. Listen, the next 4 years that you spend in high school will go by very quickly, and they will be defining years for you. So if you are ready to work hard, develop academic, social, and emotional skills in a small, safe, and supportive environment, then there's no accomplishment that you can't achieve as a Chelsea Lion. You will leave here with your CTE certification and your Regents diploma, but you will have the competitive edge when applying to internships, jobs, and colleges, because you will have also developed emotional intelligence. So strong communication skills, interpersonal skills, self-advocacy skills, problem-solving skills, the power of your unique voice, and most importantly, self-love. You will be a leader, innovator, orator, newsmaker, and a scholar full of confidence and courage. And we will be there to guide, encourage, and support you every step of the way. Well, that's my time, but remember, whether you choose Chelsea CTE or not, the one thing that no one can ever take away from you is your education. Knowledge is power. So whatever you decide, decide to grow in knowledge and understanding. Our doors are always open. So I hope to meet you soon. Be safe and stay well.
Awesome. Our next presenter will be High School of Fashion Industries, Ms. Silver.
Good evening. Thank you so much for attending the CTE Fair this evening. Very excited to present our school, the High School of Fashion Industries. My name is Danielle Silva. I am the Assistant Principal of Admissions and Family Engagement. Fashion Industries is my second home. I am embarking on my 23rd year at the High School of Fashion Industries, and I'd love to share out to all our guests about our school community. So the High School of Fashion Industries, we're known for fashion, art, and business. We're located at West 24th Street between 7th and 8th Avenue. We're centrally located near the 1 line and the C and the E. We're located in the heart of Chelsea. We are 3 blocks away from Fashion Institute of Technology, which we have partnerships with, and it's just a really great neighborhood to flourish in as a high school student. Next slide, please. The mission of the High School of Fashion Industries is to provide challenging, creative, and effective career and technical education and academic training for New York City students. So we balance the academics with our career and technical education program. We focus on 3 different areas, 3 different concentrations programs, fashion design, art photography and graphic design, and business marketing management and visual merchandising. Our school basically takes up most of 24th Street, and you'll see when we present our business program, we have 6 storefront windows, like a department store, like Macy's, Bloomingdale's, and our students are able to showcase their creativity, emphasizing our school community throughout the Chelsea area. Next slide, please. Our fashion design department is extremely unique. Our students not only learn how to illustrate via, actually we're using a new program that the industry uses called Browseware, but our students also engage in garment construction. So all the designs that you see on the slide are done by students with the supervision of teachers. And in the screen above, our students take part in designing for fashion shows, such as what's being premiered in of Harlem Fashion Week. Our students learn everything from the nuts and bolts of fashion design, from illustrating the croquis to designing children's wear, all the way to even designing wedding wear. Our portfolio requirements, we are an audition school, and students are required to submit a portfolio. Everything will be done through the high school application this year, which there will be a presentation at the end of the CTE Fair talking about the high school application, and our portfolio requirements are aligned with the New York City Audition School portfolio requirements. Please visit our website for details. We have everything posted step by step on our website. Next slide, please. Even during the pandemic, our students were able to showcase their creativity virtually. And these are examples of our student designs during our fashion show last year. Pre-pandemic, We have a huge annual fashion show. We actually have a runway built in our auditorium, which seats 1,600 participants. And we still wanted to create that nostalgia virtually to share with our school community and our family members. And these are some of the example works from our students. Next slide, please. Even though fashion is a big focus in our school, we're not just all about fashion. We have a very well-developed visual arts program. Our visual arts program focuses on painting and illustration, but also specializes in photography and graphic design. We have a photo studio built within our school, dark room, black and white photo studio, and students have their own cameras, which they're able to take pictures around the neighborhood and school and develop them on site. We have a very strong partnership with the International Center of Photography, which helps support our photography program. Our graphic design program is very unique, and our students learn how to manipulate different platforms to showcase their creative designs. Next slide, please. We also have a business marketing management and visual merchandising program. Our business program is extremely unique. Students not only market and brand their very own logo and line of fashion wear called Fly. Our students learn all the features of marketing and how to promote their own businesses and the elements of entrepreneurship. Another unique portion of our business program is our visual merchandising section of the school. As I mentioned before, our school, when you walk in, we have 6 storefront department windows, and our students design those windows. So we have window display and exhibition classes, and our students learn to do display and design just as you would do in a department store. So it's real life, hands-on industry practice. Next slide, please. We emphasize our career and technical education programs, but we know the importance of academics also. Our school offers 9 advanced placement classes along with honors classes. So our advanced placement classes that we offer are English literature, art history, biology, computer science, calculus, photography, US history, government, and psychology. We also offer honors history, honors English, honors physics, and honors chemistry. Next slide, please. We have 45 teams and clubs. After school, our teams and clubs serve a wide variety of interests. We have a skateboarding club. We have major related clubs and activities such as photography club, styling club, tailoring club. We have performance groups such as Sing. We have a phenomenal dance team, also a Latin group dance team. And our students also are able to express their beliefs through our social activism student clubs, such as our feminist club, animal for welfare club, and fashion with a purpose, which is our sustainability club. Next slide, please. We also offer varsity sports. We have girls outdoor, indoor, and cross-country track, varsity soccer, varsity softball, wrestling, boys and girls, varsity badminton, basketball, bowling, volleyball, and we have co-ed varsity stunts. Next slide, please. One of the best parts of our school is not only what goes on in the classroom, but what goes on outside the classroom. And we have a phenomenal advisory board, which brings partnerships to our school. Some of our well-known partnerships is Citizen, Kleinfeld, Macy's, Saks Fifth Avenue. We have a class specifically dedicated to our Kleinfeld bridal contest, where our students compete with one another to create bridal wear, which is judged by the Kleinfeld staff, just like Say Yes to the Dress. And one of our students are selected each year to produce and manufacture their own wedding dress design. The picture above where you see the feathers, that was designed by our students and sponsored by Swarovski. And you can't see it in the picture, but there are Swarovski crystals embedded in that design. And that was one of our premier designs in our 2018 fashion show. Down on the bottom is Leon Talley, editor at large at Vogue, who came to our window unveiling in December of 2018. And he has been principal of the Dever School. And we've had many famous icons from the industries come support our students throughout each school year, and very excited with all their support and their knowledge that they impart on our school body. Next slide, please.
And you'll be in a world of your imagination. Take a look and you'll see into your imagination. We'll begin with a spin, traveling in the world of my creation. What we'll see will defy explanation.
So we have one last slide, which advertises our opportunities to further get to know our school community. We are hosting both virtual and in-person open houses. We are also doing portfolio reviews and auditions in person every Saturday in January and February. Please visit our website at hsfi.nyc to register. I understand the fear of doing in-person events, but keep in mind when you do an in-person workshop, you're able to see the school, to find out who we are, learn the travel to our school, get to know our teachers and fellow students, and get feedback from our teachers. And it counts as an audition for your My School's submit as a portfolio when you apply to the school. Once again, thank you so much for this opportunity. We hope to hear from you, and you can contact us. Last slide, please. At hsfi.nyc, I'm Danielle Silva. I'm Danielle Silva, Assistant Principal of Admissions. We have Rosa Chavez, our admissions associate, and is basically our communicator with our families, and June Arkame, our creative marketing director, who can also help assist you. And you can always contact me at dsilva3@schools.nyc.gov. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Next school is Inwood Academy.
Good afternoon, Inwood Early College applicants. I am Dr. Simona Jo Tate, and I am the very proud founding principal here at Inwood Early College for Health and Information Technologies. If you are a young person who is interested in beginning your journey not only to high school, but to college and career readiness all at the same time, right when you begin high school, then you should consider applying to Inwood Early College. We are a very special school, only one of 9 PTEC schools in the entire city of New York. Our school is particularly special because we are partnered with New York Presbyterian Hospital, Microsoft, and Bronx Community College. And our students have the opportunity to earn their career and technical education certifications in information technology or IT, in computer science, and also in the health professions. So if you are a young person who is interested in pursuing your career interests in any of those areas, then you should definitely consider applying to Inwood Early College. We are also a really special school because you not only get an opportunity to dual enroll in college courses and earn college credits while you're still in high school, but you also have the opportunity to earn internships, and many of those are paid positions, so you get to earn while you learn. So our school is very interested in talking to you. If you are a young person who is driven, you are clear that you want to go to college and pursue your post-secondary, post-high school education, and that you are most of all a hard worker who, when times get tough, you get tougher. So if you think that describes you, I will let you listen more to some of our current students so that you can learn a little bit more about our school, and we look forward to seeing you at one of our open houses as you apply to high school. Please be sure to check out our website. That's www.inwoodec.org so that you can find information regarding our upcoming open houses. We look forward to seeing you and meeting you here in person at IEC.
Hello, my name is Diana, and these are my peers, Brandon, Shira, and Louis. I am a member of the STEM class graduating in 2025.
As a freshman at IEC, we take a class in career financial management.
Our current project is about taxes. Some people don't realize how different people contribute to our country.
Our project shows how immigrants contribute significantly to our city, state, and country's economy.
Hi, my name is Janine, and I'm a sophomore at Inwood Early College, and I'm a proud member of the Gators softball team. In the Gators softball team, we practice throughout the course of the year, and our coach Frank prepares us to play in games and in championships, which will eventually help us to get scholarships where we could play professional softball. You too could join the softball team, and we have really good sportsmanship, and we all are truly a family here at the Gators softball.
We are the Big 3 class graduating in 2023. The course we are taking is Computer Maintenance and Repair 1.
Alright, so my name is Renata Perez. I am a senior at Inwood Early College majoring for business. and in the AP Computer Science course, we are currently learning how to make pixels into an image with data. I chose this class because it's actually fun to code. Even though it's not easy when you focus, Mr. Totinski does help a lot and makes it easy.
Hi, my name is Denora Booker. I am a senior at Inwood Early College, and when we come to our school, you have the ability not only to have fun, but also learn. And when you come to our school, you have the ability to make clubs. Hey, I know I did. I made a dance club, and we call ourselves Denai. Come check us out.
Another one of our exciting programs is the Health Professions Career and Technical Education Program. This program is for those students who are thinking about careers in nursing or perhaps in some other area of the medical professional. In addition to being practitioners, students also can train to work in other elements of a hospital setting or a medical office. This is an example of your future principal practicing how to take blood pressure in one of our health professions classes.
Good afternoon, I'm Amari Morris and I'm a senior in Inwood Early College. I participate in the senior committee, the writing club, and the school play. Inwood Early College is the most welcoming to anybody, no matter your sexuality, your size, your height, or anything. Inwood Early College has helped me get a foot in to every college I've signed up for. And now, like, they won't stop calling me. I recently just enrolled into Utica College program to work over the summer to pay for my tuition. Ms. Cabrera is a leader, is the leader of the college program for Inwood Early College, and she has not rested until all my goals were achieved.
Next, we will have a brief presentation from Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis High School.
She's an inspiration for my graduate.
Fantastic. And next we will be hearing from Urban Assembly School of Emergency Management.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome and thank you for coming out tonight to start looking at high schools. You can hit us up with the first slide, please. Next one as well, please. So we are located in downtown Manhattan, directly across from One Police Plaza and underneath the Brooklyn Bridge. There are no options of trains to reach our location. We also have a major bus route that runs off of Broadway. You can go over to the next slide. So I know there's a lot of information being thrown at you tonight, so I'm going to try to be brief and concise because there's absolutely no way I can summarize my school in a few short minutes. So I'll just give you a quick couple of highlights. There is our attendance and graduation rates and post-secondary ed plans. We're very proud of what we've put out in the last couple of years. Our school's been in existence for about, we're going into our eighth year now. Last year, our students really stepped up during the pandemic and really embraced our school values and missions. In probably some of the city's darkest hours. And we actually were the first high school to ever receive the Ready Award from New York City Emergency Management for the time and energy that our students put into helping their communities. Next slide, please. We offer two main pathways at this time. We're doing a emergency medicine pathway that ends with an EMT course at BMCC. And we have a emerging cyber technology program that we've begun putting together this year and will really kick off next year. Next slide, please. So our EMT program currently, we have a cohort, we're in cohort 3 this year. Students apply to get into that program senior year, actually apply junior year, and they are selected by the college and they attend, they're dually enrolled. They get approximately 6 college credits from BMCC completely free, including uniforms. And they also get support back at the high school. So students in the EMT program actually leave the school every day around 1:30 and head over to BMCC for instruction from their staff. And I support them on the CTE side at the school. Next slide, please. And we are officially working on our cyber technology program. This is very exciting. Technology has finally reached the point this past weekend, especially with the Tonga volcano and tsunami. We're seeing how technology has really kicked in emergency response and recovery. So we are officially launching our drone program where kids at age 16 can actually get FAA certified. And we'll be offering that fully next year. Next slide, please. We definitely don't have a shortage of clubs. This list has dwindled down pretty much because of COVID. But if you can dream it, we've had it, including some really unique clubs like the FBI Explorers, and we had a CIA Explorer and the usual type stuff. Next slide, please. This is probably the proudest thing our school has done, especially for me. I am one of the founders of the school and I'm still there. We did a research project a few years back looking at healthcare equity and students, you know, regular project in class, track data and started to really notice some health inequities in their own neighborhoods. So students noticed that one of the main patterns were that cardiac arrests and choking, which is a level one priority in New York City, EMS calls were extended in certain neighborhoods for those type of calls. So we researched it, we found the problem, and we tasked the students to come up with an idea of how to attack this problem in New York City, especially since they lived in those neighborhoods. So the students came up with an idea called the Hands to Heart CPR Team. They are the only CPR team in the United States currently run by teens, and they go out to community events, other high schools. We finally are partnered up with a middle school in the Bronx that'll be announced shortly, where middle school kids will learn the skill and turnkey it out to their neighborhoods. We've learned that once kids know how to perform CPR and they master it, they're really good at training others. And we're working on getting those response rates down, especially during COVID. Ambulance EMS times were dramatically increased. So any person knowing any type of hand skills with CPR can increase survival rates. Next slide, please. Here's our drone system. We are working with a couple of different academies to get the curriculum finalized in our school. We have a brand new field that got renovated. We are currently going through the process of being a fully vetted flight area down in downtown Manhattan with NYPD. Drones are really not supposed to fly in Manhattan, but we're in the process of getting that approved. So students can literally walk down to the field and learn how to operate these drones and put them on rescue missions. Next slide, please. Sports. One of the cool things about being on a campus is that we have campus sports teams, and then we have urban assembly sports teams. So students have chances to, you know, get on different types of teams. Basic lists, standard sports. We have probably the largest athletic field in Manhattan downtown. So we have all sports paid at a home field. Next slide, please. AP courses. We currently offer AP English Language Arts, English Literature, Psychology, Calculus, and Environmental Science. Next slide, please. And you can just kind of run through these as I talk about the final slides. This is just a highlight of some of the activities we do. You can start scrolling through as I talk. Again, that's our field. We definitely spend a lot of time outside the building when possible. We take kids upstate to apple picking, usually our senior group. We spend a day up outside, outdoors. Pre-pandemic, we used to teach about pandemics, and one way of doing that was the zombie apocalypse every year on Halloween. We took a very low attendance day, and we turned it into a really fun experience. Obviously, post-pandemic, we've had to modify this a little bit. We did do it via Zoom, but it's just taken on a different significance now post-pandemic. We're just kind of embracing it. Our biggest event every year is a Thanksgiving potluck. Self-explanatory there. It's lots of food, lots of kids, lots of fun. Our ice skating trip is usually a fun day out. And every year we take the seniors out for the holiday stroll. We go see the Rockefeller Christmas tree, all the sights in Manhattan, really get to enjoy things as a communal family. And snow tubing, definitely a fun senior trip. Upstate, a full day out, enjoying the weather. Every year we have an end of year barbecue on our fields. It's usually a field day with tons of food, fun, and games. We just really try to embrace culture at the school. And definitely one of our highlights, train like a firefighter. Every year we go out to the Rock, which is Randall's Island, and our students get to suit up and literally learn skills and tasks all day long like firefighters, including putting out real fires. We have student government. They're very active in our school. They do a lot of fundraising, a lot of disaster relief. Cooking club. We have to have a cooking club. Very popular club, clearly. Especially after a long day of school. We work with a lot of different organizations with rebuilding. We do a lot of Sandy recovery work and also stuff with the Red Cross, fire sustainability, educating people about emergency plans with New York City Emergency Management as well. And we have some organizations that take our kids out on these amazing trips. We had two kids go out to Alaska. We took 16 kids a few years ago down to New Orleans. So we do a lot of outsourcing and fundraising and get kids to go on these specialized programs. We have had and we're looking forward to bringing back senior prom. And our senior trip, which we've been missing the last couple of years. But the one thing we haven't missed, and I'm very proud of, is graduation. We have yet to miss a graduation for our students, no matter what the conditions. That's our traditional graduation, and we've had some non-traditional graduations. Our students last year were highlighted during the pandemic on Good Morning America for their work in the EMT program. We had 30 students in that first cohort, and it was a rough year for our students, clearly, and the rest of New York, but their work was rewarded with a really amazing tribute by Good Morning America. And who else gets Matthew McConaughey as their valedictorian speech? Pretty cool. Because we lost that graduation, our staff refused to let our kids not have a graduation. So we, as a staff, got together and literally built a mobile float. It was highlighted on a couple of news stations, and we went door to door for each of our graduates, and we brought graduation to them. Definitely a cool experience, and probably one of the most highest points that we had during the pandemic. Like I said, our EMT program, even before we had it with BMCC, we partnered up with FDNY. A lot of our students have gone through the program even after they graduate our school. Our alumni is qualified to go through FDNY EMS Academy. It's a specialized program that runs, I believe, a shortened 2-month span. It's paid with a stipend, uniforms, and our alumni pretty much qualified to get seats in that program still to this day. And just some of our graduates and alum that have really gone on to make a difference in their communities. I'd just like to end, I guess, with one of the most important things at emergency management is skill building. Our kids need to master and learn skills, and they take that through every job field they go through. You can check us out at uasem.org. We have a new website up. Our CPR team will be offering virtual CPR training the week of Valentine's Day. So if you are interested in signing up for your family for virtual CPR, our students will be hosting a Valentine's Day week CPR classes. Just click the apply here button on our website and then write CPR in the comment field, and we'll contact you and arrange some free CPR training. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Next, we'll be hearing from Urban Assembly, Gateway High School. Principal D, you with us?
Hi, everyone. Yep, right here. Welcome. I only got one slide, but it has everything on it. So my name is Miss D. I go by D because my full last name is very, very long. I put it in the chat for those who want to try it later at dinner or after this presentation. I'm going to talk to you a little bit about my school, Urban Assembly Gateway School for Technology, or better known as UAG or UA Gateway. So we are a tech school, as the name implies. So we're located in Midtown Manhattan around Hell's Kitchen, centrally located, lots of trains. And we offer 3 pathways. So this is the school for you if you're interested in tech. If you are not interested in tech, close your ears, don't even listen. We offer 1 of 3 pathways. And so the first pathway is information technology. The second pathway is software engineering. And the third pathway is digital design and animation. And so infotech is usually for kids who are really interested in how computers work and how computers communicate with one another. It's a lot more about cloud computing, a lot more about servers, a lot more about cybersecurity, network security. So that's the pathway for you. If you're interested in building apps and how like the iPhone works, how video games are designed from a technical standpoint, then that would be software engineering. And if you are into animation and art and you love video games, but you love more of the animation of it and the characters, then we have a digital design and animation pathway. And so when you start Gateway, you all start the same place. Everyone in 9th grade kind of takes has an exposure to all 3 of those pathways. So at the end of 9th grade, you get to pick one and you focus on that for the rest of your high school career. And that's why I say you gotta love tech to come to Gateway, because you're gonna be spending about 2 or 3 hours on tech a day for the rest of your 4 years at Gateway. So the data, everyone wants to know about the data. I'm super proud of our data. Our graduation rate is 99%. Our attendance rate even now is 93% attendance. When a lot of the schools were having like 70 kids in the building, all of our kids were in the building. Our kids love being at school, and that says a lot about our culture. 97% of our kids are promoted to the next grade, and 96% of them get accepted to college. And so that's something that's really important to us, our college acceptance rate. And some of our kids do go into industry. So there's 5 things that I want you to know about Gateway. The first thing you should know about Gateway is culture first. You'll hear a lot about the UAG way, and the UAG way is all about how we create our family vibe. I always say this about Gateway, but we are so much a family, and I am your mom. We wanted a school where we would send our kids, and that's what Gateway is for me. This is a school that I would send my child to. We call you all the time. We are helicopter parents. We are helicopter guidance counselors. We are helicopter teachers. If your kid is talking to somebody, we're like, oh, I don't know that person. We're going to text you. Everyone, all the parents text me, all the parents text our guidance counselors. And that is really, really important. And that is why our culture is so great, because we keep you included in everything. I message from 4 a.m. to 10 p.m. It does not end. And that is how family is, right? Your family is going to watch out for you, not just 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. when you're in school. They're watching out for you 24/7. And that's kind of what we do. We watch out for your child 24/7, on weekends, on nights, when they're out of school, when they're in school, when they graduate. We're a family. We're in it for life. Number two thing you got to know about Gateway is the work never, ever goes away. If you don't complete an assignment in September, our guidance counselors are hunting you down for it in June. The work never goes away. And we have a structure in place for that. This is something really unique to our school. It's a program called GOLD. And GOLD is called goal-oriented development. It is 30 minutes dedicated at the end of classes where you get special support. And what that support means is a teacher teaches a class. Let's say the teacher identifies five students did not really understand the lesson that day or needed a little bit more help. The bell will ring and the teacher will say, okay, the following five kids, I need you guys to stay for GOLD. And so during GOLD is where you get that one-on-one support. This ensures that kids never get left behind, right? And so if you're waiting a week to get help, or 2 weeks to get help, by the time that you got that extra help, you're so far behind, it's really impossible to catch up. And this is also where we get you to make up work, right? So if you didn't do that assignment yesterday, I'm holding you for GOLD so you can do it. If you didn't do the assignment today, I'm holding you for GOLD so you can do it. So we never even have a situation where kids are in June not making up things from September. We catch you right away. But I need you to hear this, the work never goes away at Gateway. Number three thing you need to know about Gateway is it is very difficult to pass, but it is impossible to fail. The amount of support structures that we have in place make it impossible to fail. We have GOLD, we have 11th hour GOLD, we have super GOLD. You'll know all about GOLD if you come to Gateway. And our guidance team, we're a school of 450 and we have six members on the guidance team. We have a counselor for every single grade. We have two college advisors. We have a full-time social worker. And that's why our kids do so well. So we're providing not just the academic support, but we're providing the social emotional support. Our guidance team knows every single kid and meets with every single kid and with every single parent. And that they make every day, they're looking at their data and they make sure that no child slips through the cracks. And it's what made us do so well during this time of the pandemic, that no kids were getting incompletes and missing work. We were catching them right away. The number four thing you need to know about Gateway is instruction is exceptional. When people say, oh, this is a good school, what they mean is the teachers are good. They're not talking about the computers. They're not talking about the kids. They're not talking about the space. They're not talking about the furniture. They are talking about the teachers. Teachers make a good school. Good teaching makes a good school. And I stand behind this and I wholeheartedly believe this. And I can say this with confidence. Gateway has some of the most incredible, incredible teachers. Only the best stay at Gateway. I have no problem. If you're not the right fit for Gateway, you got to go. If I don't want you teaching my own child, then I don't want you teaching anybody else's child. And our instruction is impeccable. If you ask any of our kids, what's the best part of Gateway, they'll say the culture, and then they'll say the teachers. But the teachers help make that culture with the kids. And the number five thing you got to know about Gateway, which I said to start with, is you got to love tech. If you do not love tech, you are not going to love being at Gateway, because tech is everything at Gateway. Our kids are constantly on our computers. We have multiple labs. Our tech is state of the art. We have smart boards everywhere. We have 3D printers. We have Mac labs and PC labs. Our kids need state-of-the-art equipment because the work that they're doing is state-of-the-art, right? They're animating, they're doing digital design, they're creating apps. They need computers that can run and render and all of that. And so that's really important to know about tech, about gateways. You gotta love tech. I'm gonna put in the chat a link. This is to sign up for one of our open houses. We have one coming up that's in person next week, and then we have a few on Zoom. And I really, really want you to come to one of our open houses to learn a little bit more, because I think if you're interested in tech, this is the school you gotta check out. We are located in a shared campus, and you actually saw part of the campus because we're in the same building as Business of Sports. So if you paid attention to that tour, that is one of our, that's one of our schools in our building. And so you got to see some of the shared spaces. So I look forward to meeting you more and getting to know you. If you wanna email me, I answer every message personally. That is my email. I had to give a shortcut to the email because if you had to write out my name for the email, you would never, ever spell it right. Thank you guys so much. And I look forward to seeing you in our open house.
Thank you so much. Next we have Urban Assembly, School of Green Careers.
Yes, hi everyone. Next slide, please. My name is Mike Campanelli. I'm a school counselor at the Urban Assembly School for Green Careers. I do both academic and college and career counseling with all of our students. I've been at the school for 8 years. Next slide, please. So just to start a little bit about who we are, we're a small high school located on the Upper West Side. We are also in a shared campus. So we're in the Brandeis campus on West 84th between Amsterdam and Columbus. The Urban Assembly School for Green Careers recognizes that the economic, political, and societal impact of climate change is the biggest challenge the world faces today. We believe that many of the 21st century's careers will focus on solving the challenges of environmental injustice and in ensuring equitable access to living, to quality living and resources for all citizens. And so that is our mission statement. And so we strive through our CTE and college and career preparatory curriculums to prepare students to meet those challenges. Next slide, please. So I'm gonna start with our CTE programs. We have two technical majors at our school. So similar to the last presenter, UA Gateway, all students at Green Careers in ninth grade take a general CTE course that sort of prepares them for sustainability focused careers, teaches them a little bit about both of our majors, and then students at the end of their freshman year get to choose between our two majors. The first one is building science. So building science is a comprehensive major that incorporates elements of engineering, architecture, construction, and sustainability. In a moment, I'll show you a quick clip from our CTE programs, but a typical year in building science involves the classes building a full tiny house in their classroom. So students do everything from the framing, plumbing, electrical, roofing, siding, and even install solar panels on the house. Our second program is urban agriculture. So students are learning about horticulture, they're learning about urban farming. Pre-COVID, we had our community garden, which is located on the corner of 84th and Amsterdam. We had it set up and our students were actually running a vegetable farm stand during the summer with the produce that they were growing. We are doing a full renovation of that garden right now. We are going to be installing a greenhouse. We have beehives that are being taken care of for the winter when it's too cold for our students to go outside for class. Those will be back in the next couple of months. And students learn all about different aspects of urban agriculture. Next slide, please. So this is just a short video about our two CTE programs. Maybe that's not a short CTE, a short video. I'm sorry, folks. Am I able to share my screen and show it on mine?
You should have permission to.
Okay, thank you. Here is that.
At UAGC, we have two CTE programs. These programs introduce our students to the environmental challenges our world is facing and prepare them for careers that are tackling these problems head on. In our horticulture program, students learn about urban agriculture and plant science, all while working together to operate our 6,000 square foot learning garden. Our building science students see firsthand the intersection of architecture, construction, engineering, and applied physics. They build a high performance tiny house complete with solar panels and a compostable toilet. Both programs open pathways for our students for further study in college or entry into the 21st century.
So like I said, that's just a short clip. Desmond, would you like me to just finish out, or do you want me to pass it back to you for the screen share?
No, you can just finish out. You're here.
Okay. Okay. So that is our CTE program. Through our CTE program, we offer partnerships for work-based learning. Those are paid internships. Nearly all of our students complete at least one or two of those in their time with us. We have partnerships with the Central Park Conservancy, New York City Parks Department, Friends of Roosevelt Island, Jacobs Diggs, various others. We also have partnerships with ACE Mentoring Program. We have a partnership with City College for our College Now program. We have a partnership with A-List Test Prep for free SAT prep for our students and various others. College and career planning is a huge part of our work. As I mentioned before, that's a large part of what I do. Many of our students do go on to college. In a typical year, about 80% of our students enroll directly into college the fall after they graduate. And then about 10% enroll in a trade program and about 10% join the workforce directly. Our students go to a range of schools. Many of our students go to private colleges. And then we have many that go to SUNY and CUNY. These are just some of the schools that our students have gone to in the last year or two. We also do have articulation agreements. So those are partnerships with certain colleges that allow our students to begin with advanced standing. So SUNY Cobleskill, our horticulture students can enroll at SUNY Cobleskill, and they have advanced standing in a couple of their different plant science or agriculture programs. We also have a similar agreement with SUNY Delhi and with New York City College of Technology. Another thing that's really unique about our school is that all students take a four-year college preparatory writing sequence. So 9 through 12, you have a full year of writing in each year. And in those programs, we are using something called genre practice. So genre practice is essentially having students engage in many different types of writing. So not just your traditional, let's practice the ELA Regents writing, but students write newspaper articles, they write advertisements, they write essays, they write memoirs. And it all begins with students finding a mentor text. So that's an example of the type of writing that they'd like to engage in. Students use that mentor text to draft their first draft of their writing piece. They then get feedback from their peers and their teachers, and they engage in multiple rounds of revision to get to a final product. We really push students to think about their purpose and their audience and find their voice in writing. And this is something that we really feel strongly about and we think is a really special part of our school. In our most recent quality review, we scored in the top 10% of high schools in New York City. That was a few years ago with the pandemic, but that was 2018. A few other things that do make us different. All of our classes are mixed by grade level and age. I should also add that they're mixed by student disability status, language status. We do not believe in separating students out based on any of these factors. We believe that students when students are in an entirely mixed learning environment, then they are able to share their different perspectives, their different abilities, and really help one another to learn better and learn from each other. Almost all of our academic courses and CTE courses are co-taught. So we do have an ICT special education model at our school, but there are no segregated classes. It's not like certain kids are in the ICT class. And in fact, because almost all of our classes have co-teachers, students don't even know, you know, if they're in an ICT class or if they're not. They're all just really mixed. We do offer, as I mentioned, College Now. We have a partnership with City College. We have several AP classes. So our AP classes include English literature, calculus, AP physics, environmental science, world history, and US history. We also offer PSAL sports. Again, we're in the Brandeis campus. We have boys and girls basketball, boys and girls volleyball, boys and girls soccer, boys and girls bowling, baseball, softball, and girls tennis. We have numerous after-school activities and enrichment opportunities. In a typical year, we start the year by asking students what they would like to participate in. So we have some clubs that carry from year to year, but we also like to sort of refresh each year based on what our students are interested in doing. A few examples, we've had photography club, strategy club, we've had running club, and countless others. In addition to the internships during the school year, our partnership coordinator, who is another full-time staff person who works with students on gaining internships, works with students to apply for summer internships. Many of our students do summer youth, and many of our students work with our industry partners in the summer. Both CTE programs, as most do, culminate in an industry recognized certification. So if you're interested in learning how to be a self-starter, a curious and creative thinker, someone who knows how to work in collaborative groups, a critical reader and writer, if you're a passionate steward of the environment, and if you're a leader in your school, then UAGC is the school for you. Our code is A13A on the application, and I'm gonna put a few links into the chat. I will share a link for our school interests. If you're interested in doing a tour at our school, our weekly open house, which we do every week from 8:30 to 9:30. We have virtual and in-person options. I also put my email address, our parent coordinator's email address, and the link to our school website. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much. Now I'm just gonna quickly talk through UA School of Global Commerce. Can I get the next slide, please? So a few things that we'd like to highlight, next slide please, about UA School of Global Commerce would be the fact that, again, this is a global business school, right? So you really wanna see, as you notice here, the types of classes that students will be taking, right? Life skills, business skills, financial literacy, early college and career planning. So, and then looking at, talking about supply chain companies, universities, the school is really designed around helping students investigate and learn really how business works, not only across the world, but basically how business has become global, from local to global, and really empowering students to step into that business community. Next slide, please. Quickly, as you can also see, the school has a significant number of not only courses, but as many of the schools have, a lot of enrichment activities, including clubs and sports. Again, this is a great way for students to not only learn more about their school community, but learn about themselves, their interests, and possibly some things about, you know, future planning in terms of college and career. Next slide, please. Again, as you can just see, some interactions with the community and the sports teams, as well as, you know, just playing around with science, which is always great. Next slide, please. Sorry. Awesome. And next, we will be going to UA Harbor School. Mr. Tatarko, are you with us?
Yes. Hi, how are you? Is it all right if I just share my screen? Because I made a few adjustments to my presentation.
Absolutely. You should be good to go.
Great. Thank you very much. Hi, everybody. My name is Jeff Shaterko. I'm the principal of Urban Assembly New York Harbor School. And I'll go over a brief introduction to our school. If you don't know much about our school, hopefully you'll know a little bit more by the end of this presentation. But if you want to learn more about a school, I'll also make sure that you have the information to sign up for one of our virtual open house events that are coming up over the next 3 weeks. So let me get started. We were founded in 2003 in Bushwick, and in 2010, we moved over to Governor's Island. We are located right next to, our ferry is located right next to the Staten Island Ferry. So if you know what a Staten Island Ferry is in Manhattan, if you're looking at it, to the left of that is the Governor's Island Ferry. And all of our students, 525 of our students, take the ferry every day to come over to our school, where we engage in career and technical education, 7 different programs at our school, which I'll talk about a little bit. And right now, currently, our graduation rate is 92%. Our 7 programs are aquaculture, marine biology research program, marine policy and environmental advocacy, professional scuba diving, ocean engineering, vessel operations, and marine system technology. And once again, I won't get too deep into these programs, but if any of these programs, maritime education programs, resonate with you, then I recommend that you sign up for one of our virtual open house and you hear more about it from our students, about what we do each and every day. We partner with the Billion Oyster Project. You may have heard of the Billion Oyster Project. We're trying to restore the oysters in the New York Harbor. If you don't know, each oyster can filter 50 gallons of water a day. And if we were able to put 1 billion oysters into the New York Harbor, it would filter the harbor every 3 to 4 days, which is much needed, because if it rains more than 1/4 inch, all of the sewage from Brooklyn and Manhattan filter down into the New York Harbor. So we need to make sure that we have a way to filter the water. And in the past, back in the 1800s, we had plenty of oysters to help filter the water, but we ate all the oysters and we polluted the waterway. So we're looking to reintroduce oysters into the New York Harbor. And the students at the Urban Assembly of New York Harbor School are the ones who are doing the work alongside Billion Oyster Project. So I'll briefly show you a video of the work that our students do, and then I'll be back in about 4 minutes.
Hey guys, this is Benjamin Von Wong, and we're here today on Governor's Island shooting for the Billion Oyster Project. Our goal to highlight the kids, the heroes of the project that are actually bringing this to life.
Back when the settlers were coming in, there were oyster reefs and like mountains of them, tons of them, but we ate those away. Oysters are keystone species, and what they do is they filter the water, and any like sustenance that's in the water, they'll process that and they'll eat it. That's their food. Like one fully grown adult oyster can filter 50 gallons a day.
I'm making a tangible difference in my environment because we live in an island city, so it's really great to know that when I come out here to help, it's definitely making a difference. It's not like, oh, I'm gonna write this paper to the governor and like maybe something will happen. It's like, oh yeah, I went out sampling on Saturday. What did you do?
lot of people don't know that you can actually go diving in here. Like, there's so much to see, and it's surprising that see that there's so much underneath that green surface.
I believe that when people see these photos, they see these larger-than-life children doing amazing work, that they're going to feel more engaged, that they're going to feel like they want to participate and learn more, and hopefully get that motivation to make a difference themselves. The younger kids look up to the older kids as role models. The parents look down at their children as role models. And so it really hits a really wide demographic that I feel can really make a difference. And if there's one thing that the Billion Oyster Project is about, it's about getting everyone to believe that they can make a difference, that they can be part of this change.
An adult, pretty much, an adult can do the same thing a kid can do. It's not even that different.
Think about what you want, like, your legacy to be. What do you want to give to us? Because I don't think there's anything better than giving us a clean environment. Because we pretty much wrecked it. It's the least we can do.
And if, like, New York has beautiful waters, if you would like to go swimming and just, like, take your kids up to the Hudson one day, like, I can imagine that. Like, we're not at that point yet, but that'd be amazing because the Hudson is so beautiful.
So as you saw, it takes. All right, sorry about that. So as you can see, it does take our students quite some time to get to the school. But once they're at school, they're very excited about all the different programs that we're able to offer. And once again, I welcome you. I put in the chat opportunity for you to hear more about our school open house. I gave a breakdown in terms of data for our demographics. We're about a quarter of our students are special education students, and we meet their mandates at our school. It's one of the things we're most proud of is all of the mandates for our special education population that we're able to provide. We do take in about 140 students per ninth grade. And hopefully, you know, your child would be one of the applicants to our school. And please sign up for our open house. You can go to our website, newyorkharborschool.org. or our admissions page, which I put in the chat, where you can sign up for one of our virtual open house events. And I hope to see you there. And thank you so much for your time. And thank you for being here tonight.
Thank you so much. And next we have the Alfred E. Smith School. We'll have a, did you want to intro your school first and then we do the video?
We can start off with the video and then we'll.
Fantastic. All right, video first. Okay. Thank you, sir. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So let me explain my school, and if possible, I would like to share my screen. I have some slides I want to go over.
Got it. Go ahead.
Okay. All right. So for our graduation rate, it was 99% last year. Currently, we had 96% graduation rate, which is still pretty good, but we're going to get back up to where it should be. Our school is a CTE school that focuses on two trades. Our main trades are automotive trade and our graphic arts trade. The automotive trade is in preparation for a career in the automotive field, learning vehicle maintenance, repair, and vehicle service. And it's one of those trades where there's always a demand for those trades. It's a very hands-on trade. And it's one of those things that a lot of people don't consider when they're thinking about their view for the future. But one thing I will say about the trade, what makes it work, is there are 450 million automobiles in this country. We're the only country in the world where we have more cars than people, and they need people to service these vehicles. Okay, so the jobs are there, and these are very well-paying jobs. And what we try to do is prepare students for the chance to get an opportunity in these careers. And just going through our slides, okay, just showing you some of the shops. We have 11 shops in our school. We have two shops that are being made right now, which are gonna be state-of-the-art. They will be completed by September, and the students will get access to equipment that the trades don't even have, new welders, new frame training machines, and all this is going to be prepared them for a career in the automotive field. That's with the automotive side of our school. And again, the kids will be doing everything from basic maintenance to calculating bills to general customer service, ordering parts. And when they get into the 10th grade, they get access to the internship programs. This is from the Mercedes-Benz dealership downtown in Manhattan. We have students who work there as interns. It's a great job. Mercedes-Benz can be a difficult company to work for because they are very exacting in what they want from our students, but it's a great, valuable learning experience. So they gave us a tour of the facility. And we also have students who work there permanently who graduated and got jobs there and making a good living. So we teach skill with the automotive trades, we teach them skills that is useful. So even if they don't want to stay in the automotive field, sometimes students don't want to do that. They do learn things like how to weld, how to assemble things, how to paint. And these are skills that can carry over to multiple jobs. So focus, in addition to getting the kids ready for college and preparing them for the real world, is teaching them to be self-sufficient. Okay, so when they leave our school, they graduate with a certification, automotive certification. They learn how to, they would have had job experience working as an intern, and they will learn how to make money and be productive members of society. Okay, and that's our main focus with the automotive, with the graphic arts. The graphic arts program is graphic arts for production. So we teach them how to not only how to create a graphic image, but also how to use that skill to, again, get paid for that, how to make money for that, how to, again, not be the starving artist, but to be somebody who's out there creating things that the public wants and they can create a product that they can get paid for. Okay. And I always tell my students that everything related to, if you ever seen anything that has a picture on it, say like a t-shirt, a sneaker, any sort of image on it, that is a graphic image that somebody created from scratch and was able to market and make money for us. So that's what we teach our students with the graphic arts. They learn appreciation of the art, but in the end, they also got to learn how to use that art to be self-sufficient. Okay. So when they come in, they learn designs for communication, hand drawing, perspective, desktop presentation, Photoshop, they learn the basics. And then they get more advanced storyboarding, principles of graphic designs, how to create things like company logos, how to represent a client's idea graphically, okay?
They learn photography. That's a big portion of the 11th grades, how to use cameras, standard cameras, not just your digital cameras. And, you know, and again, how to see the world from a different perspective. You know, and again, this is all about preparing them for when they leave, how they're going to use that skill to be productive individuals and make money and take care of themselves. Okay. And when they get to their senior year, it's a production shop. This is where they actually take customer jobs as part of the school, as part of their learning process. Students will design their own yearbooks. They design the layout, they do all the photography, and we do everything in-house when it comes to the yearbooks. It's all, we have our full print shop. So we get our photography studios, we got our students, we have our print shop, and we can make everything that we need to do to create a yearbook. So that's, again, it's a hands-on experience. And if you don't mind, if you like, I would say if you have a creative personality, if you like using your imagination to try and create something new, different, graphic arts is something that you can definitely enjoy. When it comes to the automotive, if you don't mind getting dirty and like to work on vehicles and again, make repairs, that's where the automotive comes in. So our school, we start everybody off in the 9th grade when it comes to the CTE programs. So as soon as they come in, whether they take an automotive or graphics, they're gonna get that full immersion of the subject. With the automotive, we start you off with basic automotive designs and principles and tools on safety, how to work on a car. And with the graphic arts, again, the idea is to do it as soon as possible. So by the time you're a senior, you would have had your internships done, you would have had experience. And again, when you leave or ready to leave, we can actually help students find jobs. We have a lot of business connections, industry connections for the automotive and the graphics. We got a lot of our students who work for BMW, work for Toyota, also working for the city of New York in different job capacities permanently. Like I know NYPD loves hiring our automotive students to work on their police cars. They have such a huge fleet of vehicles and they always need somebody to do the vehicle service and maintenance. So that's something that's good for our students. Now I know I spent a lot of time talking about the trades, but real quick, we do have all the academic subjects that the kids need. We do have AP classes, but I tend to focus more on what makes our school different, and that is our CTE programs. It is a full immersion program. You are working with your hands. You are participating every day and learning the subject matter. Now, we're going to have open house this Saturday. If we contact I'm going to put our web address in the chat, and there's a sign-in form. Just let us know that you're coming. We're going to be there this Saturday from 9 to 11, and then we're going to have a virtual open house from 11 to 12. So, and if you, for whatever reason, can't attend the open house, contact us at school. Just say you can't come in, or we'll pick a day that you could come in, and we'll give you a tour of the building, give you a chance for students. Program is for you. It's not for everybody, but because it is hard work, I'm not going to deny that. Learning a trade is hard work, but there are great rewards with that. And hopefully at the end, you can find yourself in a position or a job that you're going to feel happy with, where you can just start your career and work comfortably, the way you want. So, let's see, I think that is it. Yes, I think I covered all the basics. So I'm gonna put the information in the chat, and if you, again, just sign in, and we'll be there this Saturday from 9 to 11, okay? Thank you.
Thank you so much. And next we have Bronx Design and Construction Academy. Mr. Hicks.
Welcome, welcome. Thank you. All right, can I present my screen?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. One second, guys. All right, welcome everyone. I am here with my colleague, Ms. Bonilla. My name is Mr. Hicks. I am a guidance counselor at Bronx Design and Construction Academy, and Ms. Bonilla is here as well. She's also one of our guidance counselors as well. So you can see our contact information below. We have an Instagram page, we have a school website, and we also have a YouTube channel as well. So we are Bronx Design and Construction Academy at CTE High School, located in the Alfred E. Smith campus. And that's, I guess, why we just presented after Alfred E. Smith. We were founded in 2011, and we have graduated a total of 6 classes at this time. Well, it's actually we made 7 of the day. So what makes us our school really great is you can graduate with a CTE endorsement, all right? An endorsement essentially recognizes 2 years of work experience, which is pretty amazing. I hope that you guys can see me. I'm not blocking this, but anyway, perfect. Here we go. There we go. So we're going to talk about the pathways and how you can enter our school. Ms. Bonilla, you want to start about our 2 pathways?
Yes, so there's 2 pathways that we can, when applying to our school, you can actually apply through our architecture program, which you would start automatically from your 9th grade all the way through your 12th grade year, or you can apply to our building trades. If you apply to our building trades, your 9th grade year, you would go through a rotation of our trades. And then at the end of their 9th grade year, you will choose which trades you are most interested in, a scale from 1 to 4. And then from there, we would put you in your first choice or your second choice. And then your 10th grade year, you will start, based on your choices, you will start your trades. So if you choose architecture, your 9th grade year, you will start with manual drafting. Your 10th grade year, you would go through computer drafting, which is going to be 1.5 periods. And then 11th grade, you will go through 3D computer drafting, which will take 2.5 periods of your schedule. And your last year of architecture, you would have something called Revit, which is going to be 3 periods of your schedule. If you choose our building trades, like I said, your 9th grade year, you will go through a rotation. Some of our building trades, it's plumbing, HVAC, carpentry, and electrical. We try to match our students with the first choice that they choose. And then your 10th grade year, like I said, you will choose your trade, and then you will have 1.5 periods of the trade. And 11th grade year, you will have 2.5 periods of your trade. And 12th grade year, again, you will have 3 periods of our trade. These are some of the pictures of our students working. This is a picture of our house of the 12th grade students that build the house. And usually we have a functioning house by the end of the year, which is pretty cool. And these are pictures of our students working.
Thank you, Ms. Bonilla. So before I continue, I just want to mention, this is what really sets our school apart, the 5 building trades that we have, okay? Well, the 5 trades that we have, that just gives students options, being able to choose HVAC, carpentry, electrical, or plumbing. That's an amazing opportunity, all right? So students will go through that rotation, as Ms. Bonilla said, and they will have choice. So I think that's something to recognize when it comes to Bronx Design, is just a matter of choice. And speaking about choice, a lot of our students, or all of our 12th grade students, end up having this choice, all right? They could choose college, career, or they could choose both. And, you know, we've had students do both and do really well. And we've had students do one and do really well. For instance, most of our architects, they trend towards college. But if they didn't want to go to college, they end up pursuing a job in the sheet metal union, which is popular for our architect students. A lot of our students that are in electrical trends towards the MTA or Local One. Our plumbing students also go to Local One Plumbing. Our carpentry students go either into the private industry or they go into one of the local carpentry unions. And our HVAC students go into private industry more so than anything. And we have affiliations with employers. I'll talk to you guys about that very soon. But this is a real big thing. We had a student that was crying because of the options that she had, and she did not know what to do because she had a big salary position waiting for her upon graduation, but she also got a bunch of college acceptances, and she literally just was plagued with her choices. So we are good when it comes to presenting choices to our students. These are some of our industry partnerships, as you can see, both public and private partnerships, and the list goes on. This is not even all of them. So we do have a lot of partnerships that we've developed over the years. Construction skills is one of the major programs that we send students off to upon graduating. They actually engage in this program in the spring of their senior year. And essentially this program puts them, is a pathway to the local unions. The SVA program is essentially where our CT teachers came from. All of our CT teachers, all of them came from the SVA program. And we are actually employing some of our students through this program as well. We have many students that are actually teachers in the school right now that have gone to Bronx Design or the Alfred E. Smith campus when it was. So one of the requirements in order to get your endorsement is to do an internship. So we still have internships, even during the pandemic. They're all paid internships. Students do earn certifications here. OSHA 10 is one of the big certifications, but there's, you know, OSHA 30, NICER Core, the Bronze, the NORA Bronze certification, Solar One installation, and we also have driver's ed. We're trying to get that program back. Just full disclosure, we don't have that this year, but we are hoping to gain that program back. We have many articulation agreements and partnerships with colleges. We have an articulation agreement with Pima College, SUNY Delhi, City Tech, and NYIT. We also have the College Now program through Host Hills Community College. Our students actually start taking college courses as soon as 10th grade. We have the High School to Work program where we partner with Strayer University, where our students last year graduated with an associate's degree. Not all of our students, but a select number of our students who engaged in this program. They were going to high school and college at the same time. Our AP courses that we have to offer are English Literature, Environmental Science, US History, and 2D Art. And these are our sports. We are partnered with the Alfred E. Smith Campus Sports, so we offer basketball, football, flag football, bowling, baseball, soccer, track, and wrestling. So we are having open houses coming up, so please visit us at our Bronx Design website so that you can get more information about upcoming open houses and whatever other questions you have, we're here to answer. Thank you all.
Thank you so much. And now we will be hearing from HERO, Health Education and Research Occupations. Quick video.
As high school recruitment season begins in New York City, eighth graders and their parents ask themselves, what am I looking for in a high school? The real question is, what kind of life do you want to build for yourself? At HERO High, you will join a hardworking community where students are given the space to find their unique gifts and commit to a personal mission that will help them get the most out of their education, succeed at the highest levels of their career, and change the world for the better. The journey starts with exploring the vibrant economy of New York City and the career pathways we offer at our school, including healthcare, nonprofit management, nonprofit management and the arts, and education.
Our healthcare pathway is the most direct route to becoming a doctor or a nurse. The COVID-19 epidemic has shown us that it is more important than ever to train more Black and Latino doctors and nurses to serve our Bronx communities. Come to Hero High and change the world by healing your community.
I attended LaGuardia High School and had a career in dance before I became a teacher. I think students in every borough should have access to great training in the arts, as well as preparation to lead arts organization after college. You can also build your career working on issues that are important to you, like protecting the environment, ending racism, or improving access to mental health care. And prepare to lead one of the largest sectors of the NYC economy. You can change the world by making a difference in your community.
I love being a teacher. It's the best thing in the world to wake up every day and help young people learn about important and exciting ideas. Young people in the Bronx need smart teachers who can relate to their lives. If you choose the education pathway, you can train to be a teacher or work in a school and change the world by educating your community.
Every student in HERO gets training in healthcare, nonprofit management, or education. We go on field trips every Friday afternoon, provide students with mentoring and job shadowing in the field they are preparing to enter. And we have one of the largest paid internship programs in the city. Our partners include some of the largest and most innovative employers in New York City, including Montefiore Medical Center, Central Park Summer Stage, the Whitney Museum, MoMA, NMIC, and the New York City Department of Education.
But that's not all. We're also an early college school and a PTEC high school. This means that students can take real college classes as early as the summer after ninth grade and stay for a supported two-year college degree at no cost to students or families. This can help students gain entry into the most competitive four-year colleges and in-demand careers.
You can also earn certificates and micro-credentials in CNA, EMT, personal training assisting, restorative justice, peer mediation, and project management, so that you can earn more money while you're finishing your college and graduate degrees.
It's not all about work, we also have fun too.
My favorite school event is the Teachers vs. Student basketball game.
My favorite trip was the Bobby Machu when we got to zip line.
I love the year-end shows because we get to see everyone's talent.
My favorite after-school club is student government.
I'm on the softball team and I love it because we all come together as one big family.
I love my relationship with my teachers and my advisors.
I love the energy of the school and how you can choose your own path.
Our students are brilliant people. We know they need lots of activities and choices to keep them interested and help them grow their minds and their talents. So we make sure we have lots of clubs and activities.
I love Her Story because it is a safe space to express your emotions and a place where you get the chance to build a sisterhood.
The reason why I love Builders Club is because it's a place where you could sit down, talk, and build stuff with your friends.
I love cheerleading because I can be my goofy self, and also I feel like I have a family in this school, and it's fun.
We have spent many years building our athletics program. We have real coaches who carefully support the growth of our student athletes.
We have a real student government that has a say in how the school is run. We meet with the principal, make positive changes in the school, and sponsor events.
As a parent, you can feel comfortable sending your child to HERO. Their advisory program means that you always know who to call when you need to talk to someone at the school. There's a counselor for every grade, so students can get therapy in school if they need it. And they also find ways to challenge every student, so they are truly prepared for college and career. At HERO, I understood that even if my child isn't perfect, he can still be someone.
HERO is a high school. Sometimes there are issues, but we can promise that every problem will be addressed quickly and fairly, and that parents will be kept informed. We know that no one knows and loves a child as much as their parent.
So we learn as much from you as possible so we can partner with you
to give your child the best possible support.
Hero High has been a successful small school for 8 years, and now we are growing up.
In the fall of 2022, we will occupy the top 3 floors of the Gompers campus. And this is not all we plan to do.
We will continue to grow
so we can be there for our students and families as you grow.
When I was looking for a job, Hero was there to help.
I know I can count on Hero to help as I progress in my career.
At Hero High, we have your back for life.
I came to Hero
to become the hero
I know I can be.
I know I can trust Hero High to help my child become the hero I've always known was inside of them.
Come to Hero and become the hero you know you can be.
As high school recruitment season begins in New York City, eighth graders and their parents ask themselves, what am I looking for in a high school? The real question is, what kind of life do you want to build for yourself? At Hero High, you will join a hardworking community where students are...
Yes, now, finally, the last school of the evening presenting is HSET. Do we still have Mr. Hodder here?
Yes, I am here. Good evening, everybody.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Mr. Hodder. We'll get the slides up momentarily. I'm sorry.
No problem.
Next slide, please. Awesome. There you go.
So I am Mr. Hodder. Nice to meet everyone. I'm one of the school counselors at the school, the High School for Energy and Technology. We're located in the Bronx. We're by the Bronx Zoo, by the Fordham area, and Fordham University, just to give you an idea. We're in a shared campus, but we are located in the majority of the floors of the campus. Next slide, please. There's so much to share about our school, but in such a little few minutes, I want to focus on our CTE program. Our main program is our electrical installation and practice CTE pathway. Next, please. This program covers an overview of careers within the electrical fields. It also covers the practical applications of working with basic hand tools and power tools common in the industry. Next slide, please. Just a brief overview, some of the things in the electrical CTE program that you go over in ninth grade is safety. And you start information and learn about OSHA safety. At the end, get the opportunity to earn an OSHA certification. Next slide, please. So some of the other topics that are also learned about by our students in the ninth grade is cable systems, raceways, boxes, covers, devices, lighting systems, etc. Next slide, please. These are some images so you could see. Next slide, please. These are some of the projects and some of the assignments our students work and have completed in the program and in their classes. So next slide, I think is 2 more pictures if you could just go through them. Again, additional student work that happens at our school. Next slide, please. We're also part of Skills USA. It's one of our, our students get the opportunity to do competitions and work together and get some skills that they could then get prepared for careers in trade, technical, and skilled service occupations. Next slide, please. In 10th grade, You got a little bit of experience with job layout, wiring method, or recurrent overcurrent protection, electrical remodeling. Next slide, please. 11th grade, you focus more on circuit layouts. Next slide, please. And basic control circuits. Next slide, please. 12th grade, focus on commercial industrial applications. Next slide, please. And again, safety. Next, please. Motor controls. Next slide, please. And eventually you get your OSHA certification. Next slide, please. Before moving into our other programs that we're starting or working on, our students have had the opportunity and are currently applying for and participate in internships and eventually get job placements with companies such as MTA, and also Con Edison. Our next program that our school offers is Career Financial Management. Next slide, please. These are some of the topics within this section. Students learn about taxes, how to file taxes, important information that they should know about their taxes. Next slide, please. Loans, home ownership, credit, and importance of credit score and everything that has to do with having a good credit score and maintaining it. Next slide, please. Also, our students learn about New York Stock Exchange. There we have a club after school that focuses on this as well. Next slide, please. Also something new that was started and in the works to be part of our CTE pathways is digital communications and media program. Next slide, please. In this program, students get to concentrate on digital imaging, digital illustration, and digital video production. Next slide, please. These are some examples. Usually in the ninth grade, students are working on Photoshop, which includes photos, digital illustration, flyers, et cetera. 10th grade, digital imaging, again, continuing to work with Photoshop. 10th, 11th grade, digital illustration. Here includes designs, logo design, characters, design of characters as you see in the picture, as well as art, digital art. And then in 12th grade, our students focus and learn on digital video production. Next slide, please. So these are some of the projects. These are some of the work from our students. Digital photography, flyer design, business card, typography. Next slide, please. Again, these are some flyers and more work that our students have created in the class. Next slide, please. These are some of the projects completed for digital illustration. Portraits, character art with their design, logo designing as well. Next slide, please. These are digital video projects, so documentaries, trailers, interviews, PSAs. Next slide, please. Okay, so those are our main CTE programs and some that are in the works of being finalized. This is the code that you would use to apply to our school. If you're interested in any of the shared CTE programs we offer and courses, Y65A. I'm gonna put the website was listed. Thank you on the chat. I'll also add my email for everyone. We've had open houses in person and virtual on our website. There's the link, but also I'm willing, I've been to middle schools in person. If you didn't make it to one of our open houses or virtual or in person, feel free to reach out to me and we could set something up for a tour. We have other awesome things such as sports. We have baseball, basketball, other clubs that students love, our dance, guitar club, anime, media, like I mentioned, financial club. We have work, learn opportunities, summer youth for students with the chance to be in school, but also get to work during the summer, and much more. So if you want to know more about our school, feel free to reach out to me, go to our website, and we could set a tour and another future virtual open house and in-person dates. Thanks to everyone. Thanks for having us and have a great night.
Thank you so much. And last but not least, we would like to introduce one of our great collaborators, our New York State Transition and College Access Centers. Ms. Roman, are you with us?
Yes, I am. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Awesome. Good evening, everyone. My name is Carmen Roman, and I am the director of the Bronx Transition and College Access Center. And I'm excited to have the opportunity to share some information tonight on the Transition to College Access Centers, or the TCACs. Okay, so I'm just gonna drop my email in the chat very quickly. Here we go. Awesome. Okay, so here's our mission statement. The Transition to College Access Centers support schools and families by facilitating a seamless transition for students from school to adult life. All students are provided with experiences that foster their academic, social, emotional, and vocational growth and excellence, facilitating multiple pathways to graduation and success after high school. Next slide, please. So this graphic here just kind of shows the stakeholders within our community. So TCACs overall, we support families, post-secondary institutions, business entities, educators, and community-based organizations. So we stand as a resource. So we're connecting all of these different stakeholders in order to support students a successful transition into post-secondary life. Next slide, please. I'll quickly go over some of these goals, but just to name a few of our goals, we engage community-based organizations and businesses to establish, maintain, and increase work-based learning opportunities and employment access for students with disabilities. We also engage families in the transition and post-secondary planning process through student and family-centered workshops, which I'll discuss later. We also develop and lead ongoing evidence-based professional development for staff in the areas of college and career readiness and transition planning services. Next slide, please. So for our training opportunities program, or TOP program. This is one of our paid work-based learning programs. So the TOP program is designed to support schools' efforts in guiding students with individualized education programs, or IEPs, through work-based learning experiences that will facilitate their achievement of measurable post-secondary goals. Through a coordinated set of activities and related instructions, students are provided with opportunities to develop and master competencies related to transferable work and life skills. And this is just some information based off of this year's TOP program. Next slide, please. And we also offer summer youth. So students with IEPs that apply to our summer youth program tend to have a better chance of being selected in the lottery. And as you know, summer youth is an engaging program that offers opportunities for students to learn new skills, explore potential careers, and earn money. Next slide, please. Who is eligible to apply through TCAC? So we support students between the ages of 14 through 21 who have IEPs. You have to be a current resident of one of the five boroughs of New York City and currently enrolled in New York City Public School. The students between the ages of 16 and 17 must be legally authorized to work in the United States, and students between the ages of 14 through 15 do not need working papers. This is for our TOP program. Next slide, please. Okay, so TCAC, Pre-Employment Transition Services. We also offer pre-EDS. Okay, so what is pre-EDS? The TCACs will provide pre-employment and transition services to eligible students with disabilities as they prepare for life after high school and experience post-secondary success. The pre-EDS focuses on job exploration, work-based learning, counseling on post-secondary options, workplace readiness training, and instruction in self-advocacy. Next slide, please. We may have gone over these already, but it's just giving you a little bit more information about what's involved with each area of focus for the pre-EDS. Okay, next slide, please. We also do have an application for a pre-EDS, and here's some information on who is eligible. New York City students with an IEP or 504. So you don't have to just have IEP, you can have a 504. This is our partnership with Access VR, state-based partnership. So between the ages of 14 and 21, who are potentially eligible for vocational rehabilitation services but are not currently receiving services through Access VR. I have some information on pre-EDS I can share. If you're interested, you can just email. I'm not sure why the Bronx's email address isn't there, but I'm just gonna take that opportunity to drop all of the borough TCAC email addresses into the chat at this time. There is one TCAC for each borough, as I may have mentioned before. So let me just drop that in right now. Awesome. And the application would just require a signature, and each one of these TCACs can answer any questions you may have on pre-EDS. I'm not sure if I have another slide, but next slide, please. Oh, great, yes. So this is back in the order. So our professional learning catalog, we offer a series of workshops, and I'm just gonna go ahead and just to save with the interest of time, just drop in the chat a link to our catalog. And this catalog includes the workshops that are offered for our stakeholders. Hopefully that is a link when it comes through. If not, I can drop it in separately. Let's drop it in right below. All right, there's the link. So for students, for example, you're gonna have college considerations, resume writing. For families, we offer transition planning for families, navigating college in a virtual world, post-secondary funding options. For school staff, we offer understanding and facilitating transition planning, writing effective transition goals. Also, we offer for community partners, supporting diverse learners in the workplace. CTE educator series includes knowing and supporting students with IEPs, building effective partnerships for ELLs and students with IEPs, and the role of work-based learning in transition planning for students with IEPs. And of course, we have a paraprofessional series as well, using virtual platforms, present level of performance in an IEP, instruction in a remote blended learning setting, and more. So next slide, please. And finally, these are all of the Transition College Access Centers throughout the city. Again, I am the director for the Bronx Transition and College Access Center, and I believe Manhattan's the other borough represented in this fair. Manhattan team is phenomenal. They're actually the third slide there. You may not, the third square, you may not be able to see it, just says Access Center, but they are the third one on the right, located on 35th Street. If you wanted to grab their information. And every week we host open office hours from on Wednesdays from 5 to 6. All of that information is also available on each TCAC's website. You can just email us if you need any additional information. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Ms. Roman. I'm sorry to mispronounce your name earlier. So folks, we're almost finished. We just wanted to share a few details about the next steps for anyone applying for high school. Next slide, please. The My Schools Online High School Directory. This is the My School Online High School Directory and application. You go to myschools.nyc. This is what it looks like. Next slide, please. Well, yeah, and you would click in the upper right-hand corner where you can choose your preferred language. Next slide, please. When you're at myschools.nyc, you will need to scroll all the way down to the bottom of the page where you will see Start Browsing, and that's what you want to click on. You will, to view the online searchable directory. You see the search box. You will see the same buttons. You can use these to narrow down your search. Next slide, please. Based on what is important to you. If you click on more features, you can explore other options. You can choose to see schools only in certain boroughs from here. Click career and technical education to select schools and programs that offer CTE. You can choose more than one filter, such as a particular borough and a career in technical education, and you will see CTE options within that borough or boroughs that you have selected. Next slide, please. You can create an account and add your child in My Schools now. You can explore schools and programs online in My Schools, like we showed you by using the filters. The high school application will open later this month, actually next week, the 24th, and you can attend high school family presentations hosted by the Office of Student Enrollment the week of January 24th, that is next week. To sign up to receive notifications from the Office of Student Enrollment, including information about their events, please visit schools.nyc.gov/signup. Next slide, please. Please also remember, for more information about CTE schools and programs, please visit cte.nyc. For questions, please feel free to email ctenyc@strongschools.nyc. Thank you so much for your time. We know that it's been a really long night, but we appreciate you, and we hope that you have gotten some good information, and we wish you good luck in your high school admissions process. Have a great evening.